Herbicide resistance is a growing problem in Western Canada. To stay ahead of the tough-to-control weeds that result from this issue, it's important to take a hard look at management strategies. For instance, how does a one-pass application of a single mode of action herbicide stack up? In addition to resistant weed escapes, secondary flushes of weeds can return to take over the field. Simply put, not good enough. But what about using multiple modes of action in a single pass? While you can get control of resistant biotypes, secondary flushes return, grow larger, and prove even more difficult to control later. In other words, good, but not ideal. Your best plan of attack is managing weeds throughout the season with multiple modes of action and herbicide layering. Applying a pre-seed or pre-emerge herbicide with residual activity gives you a cleaner, weed-free start. A residual herbicide remains active in the soil for an extended period of time to control germinating or newly emerged weeds. It also improves the effectiveness of your in-crop herbicide because the total weed density is lower and weeds are smaller and more uniform in size. In order to be effective, a residual herbicide requires the right level of moisture so it can move into the soil and reach the targeted weeds. The rule of thumb is you need a half inch of rain following application. Otherwise, conditions will be too dry and reduce the effectiveness of the herbicide's residual component. If there isn't sufficient rain, you'll still get burn down of emerged weeds and the residual component of the herbicide can remain on the surface for several weeks. When rain does come, it'll activate the residual herbicide, providing activity on the newly germinating weeds. The practice of applying different modes of action sequentially while rotating chemistries is known as herbicide layering, which is otherwise known as ideal for growing what you meant to grow in the first place.
Woohoo!
And the ideal way to achieve all of this is through advanced weed control solutions from BASF, including Heat LQ or Heat Complete, followed by Viper ADV for peas. For Clearfield lentils, Heat Complete, followed by Solo Ultra or Odyssey Ultra NXT. For glyphosate-tolerant soybeans, Heat LQ or Heat Complete, followed by Viper ADV. For dicamba-tolerant soybeans, Ingenia plus Heat LQ or Heat Complete, followed by Viper ADV. For corn, Heat LQ or Heat Complete, followed by Armazon. At BASF, we're so confident in the advanced weed control program, we provide additional respray support for weed escapes, even resistant biotypes. That's an industry first. For more information on respray support, contact your BASF sales representative or call Ag Solutions Customer Care. To learn more about herbicide layering, use the following link. BASF, we create chemistry.